Just whip those bitches and show them who's boss.
Hey YouTube, what's going on? Hope y'all are having a dope ass day today. It's your boy Alex and I am back today with another reaction video. Continuing our ABCs of Metal journey, today we are on the letter G. Bitch, real G's move in silence like lasagna. Which only makes sense to be jamming some Gojira. I have not heard the song The Art of Dying, and that was the most requested for song on the Flesh God Apocalypse reaction. So we're gonna be checking out the song The Art of Dying. Now this is a 10 minute song. I know y'all are busy people with some important shit to do, so we're jumping right into the song. Let's get into it. Link to the original video will be down below in the description. Y'all make sure to check it out if you want to. Let me grab these fucking headphones. For those of y'all that don't know, check this clip out. Link to that vlog will be down below at the top of the description, and let's get into it. It was one of the coolest moments of my life, dude. Okay, let's go. Weird. That's gotta go a bounce to it. Dude, I like this already. This is a nice, slow, gradual buildup. I love that. Intros, outros, I love that whole type of thing, dude.
Oh.
Damn. I got the lyrics pulled up right now too, and this is nuts, man. Those drums though, oh my god. Mastered the art of not only making extremely heavy music, but as much as it is heavy, it is equally as beautiful. It's a dark, beautiful song. God, man, why have I not been exposed to this yet? My big ass water bottle. You can't time Gojira! No fucking way, man! I feel like I'm in a badass scene of Cobra Kai with this shit going on in the background, dude. It's insane, man. I love the fact that Gojira allows their fans to really absorb the music and listen to all of it. They don't rush through things. They let you enjoy every ounce of this song. It's exactly what you want, the missing element in today's music. You know what I'm saying? That makes me want to start picking up drums, goddammit. Whenever the band makes you want to learn instruments, badass. So cool. That makes me just want to do it. This makes me happy. At the beginning of the song, I told you how much I loved intros and outros. That's exactly what this is. There's such a gradual increase until the top, and then such a gradual decline, man. It's just amazingly smooth. That's gonna be stuck in my head. Na 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 na, that's sick. Na 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 na. Dude, that fucking, that rides, bro. And I don't even know how to headbang to that. I just want to go every different direction. That's badass. Got a minute 20 left. It's just gonna be a... Wow. Mm-hmm. So this part right here, I'm reading something about the song. The strings of the guitars in this song are tuned down to C standard or two whole steps below E standard tuning. Most Gojira songs are either D standard, one whole step down, or D drop C, similar to D standard, but lowest string is dropped to C. With only a few exceptions, C standard allows for a deeper and heavier sound than higher pitch tunings, and is frequently employed by doom, stoner, and extreme genres of metal. This effect is most noticeable during the repeated riff in the outro of the song. Dude, yeah, it's like, it's definitely got those feelings of doom, right? Of this impending doom, but it sounds so cool because the song's got that authority to it and it just brings you along for the ride. This is a journey. It's not a song, it's an experience. Seriously, that's what it is. And I mean the lyrical content, dude, we dive into the lyrics, starting off breathing slowly, mechanical heartbeat. He's becoming lifeless. He's getting into this state of mind, not even state of mind, state of being where you don't have any life in you. I haven't closed my eyes in a long time. He's been stressed, he's been working, he's been overdoing it. He's been sacrificing his health, both physical and mental well-being, neglected emotions, catastrophic voyage. I cannot stomach these forms and colors anymore. This colors, this facade, he needs something authentic, something genuine. None of this bullshit that society is stuck on, right? And then verse 4, I won't bring any materials to the afterlife. Take no possessions, I would rather travel the light. I'm of this kind that kills all day, but I don't know yet how to die. Genius says that it's a reference to a Buddhist concept of detachment. It means that you hold no real emotional attachment to anything in his life because this life is temporary. Travel light most likely means travel with no weight or burdens. In other words, no material possessions as luggage. But if you're creative enough, you could say it's about light as in some kind of magical metaphysical light. You know what I'm saying? So like, Gojira does an amazing job of having a beautifully dark, haunting sound, but touching on very pressing topics. Not only topics that are prevalent in today's day and age, but just these topics that make you think, that are very introspective, and that's why I love this band so much, dude. Thank you guys for telling me about this song. I really enjoy that, and I cannot wait for tomorrow's song. And based on this, y'all's judgment is fucking awesome. So with that being said, that's where you guys come in, because I need your help. Drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this song, this group, this video in general, but also let me know what song and band you want me to do tomorrow for letter H. And with that being said, keep smiling, keep being yourself. Don't let anybody throw shade at you. I will see you tomorrow. That's a motherfucking fact. Oh yeah. And don't forget, the link to the ABCs of Metal Spotify playlist is linked in the top of the description too. I love you guys. I'll see you tomorrow. That's a motherfucking fact. Oh yeah. Peace.